G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter here today, and what we're going to do is have a quick look at the Xstream 7 reverse osmosis system, okay? And no secrets, as far as reverse osmosis systems go, I don't mind this one here. It's an absolute ripper. And the reason I say that is because the quality of the water that flows out of this tap after the filtration stages and what it can do to the water before you consume and drink it, okay? So as you can see here, we just gently laid everything out on the table. It is a full system, you can see it on the website, and it comes with everything that you'll need to put it together, okay? Now, before I start, if you're in the market for an RO, I really like this one here for bore water. And the reason for that is bore water is just probably gonna be a bit sedimenty and have a few lumps and bumps in the water. And the water comes in from the this side here, and this is the sediment cartridge. And as you can see here, I've grabbed a replacement cartridge pack. So this is the first sediment that goes in the first one. And this is the carbon cartridge that goes in the second one, sediment carbon. And it's $30 to have the pair of them delivered to your house. So it's just very, very cheap to change the cartridges. So if you've got bore water and it's got a bit of crap in it and you've got to change them over every 6 months because of the water quality, then it's not too big a problem, all right? Some of the other systems just, it might be hundreds of dollars, but good old fashioned style, these housings here, we test them, they've tested right up to thousands of kilopascals, so they've got really good holding capacity and they'll do the job for you on the pump. Okay, obviously we've got a pressure limiting valve that'll get installed on that side there to stop any sudden surges, and we're good to go. So water comes into the Xstream 7, filtered through the sediment, filtered through the carbon, and then it comes up and goes through the membrane. Once the water flows through the membrane, not just on this system, any RO, doesn't matter the shape, the size, the country it's made in, or the stickers on it, whatever it is, once the water comes out of the RO and reverse osmosis system comes out of the membrane, it's stripped all of the contaminants out of the water, it's stripped all the mineral out of the water, and you've got water now which is about a pH of about 6. That water is going to flow into the tank, it's going to fill the tank up, and inside this tank is a bladder. And as the water comes in, pushed by the pump or just the mains pressure if you're on government water, the water comes through the system, comes out of the membrane, going into the tank, and it's going to fill the tank up. Have about 9 litres up your sleeve in here all the time. Now the reason the water's in the tank here is because these membranes split the water and they just create very, very fine water, but very, very slowly. Probably 200 mils a minute, depending on your incoming water quality and more so the water pressure that you've got available at your home. So very slow, 200 mils a minute, you know, it's not enough to pour out of the tap. So it pushes it into the storage tank. There's a bladder in the tank. So once the tank's filled up or half full, whenever you hit the faucet on the sink, the bladder inside the tank expands, pushes the water out, and the water will come up and it'll come out of the tap on the faucet on the sink. And it'll do that for about 9 litres straight, run for a couple of minutes, and then obviously it'll wear out. The system will automatically start creating water again as soon as you hit the faucet, even though this tank is pushing the water out of the faucet at the same time. As soon as the water stops coming out the faucet, water will start flowing into the tank again, and the tank will fill up again and you'll be good to go. All right. When the water leaves the tank and it's on its path back up to the faucet, well, that's when it's going to come along, and this is the new model here. We've got the T300. So this is a hydrogen rich cartridge. That's why it's been upgraded, the Xstream 7. And it's going to generate, it's hydrogen, so it's generating oxygen in the water. So considering the membranes tend to take a bit of the oxygen out as well, it's a great asset to a system like this. The pH of the water will go in at 6, and it's going to come out the other end 8, 8.5 when they're new, and it'll elevate the pH of the water up very nicely and quite high. Swings around. This one here is the infrared balls, okay? Acid in the body, and it's good for the heart, and it's just got a lot of health benefits, the infrared treatment. And then it flows around the end. This is just a normal inline carbon cartridge on the top, and that'll polish the water up and just make it nice and sweet and beautiful for you to drink. The water comes out the end. This little red one here, and we do have them in blue as well, that's a magnet, okay? It's a negative magnet. Us human beings are negative with a negative charge, and this negative magnet puts a negative charge on the water and just makes it super, super for us to drink, okay? So you can see why I like it. It's just got a few extra benefits that most RO systems don't have. It's a great price. It comes as a full system, and everything you need here is ready to go. The box with the faucet in it, there's the watermark connection that goes up underneath the sink that we run the water off. Obviously the pressure limiting valve I mentioned before that'll go on the side there. In the kit here is all the tool to undo the bottom housing, etc. There's a little tap in there to go up on top of the tank to turn the tap on and off, and just the all the fittings and fixtures that you're going to need. In any of these systems, they might sound complicated, but they really aren't. Basically, we connect this one up under the sink and the water will come down through the pressure limiting valve and enter the system. The water comes through one and two into the membrane. On the membrane, there is a couple of pipes on the back, obviously, and you can look on the end here. We've got them marked for you. Tank, drain, water feed in. So water goes in this one here, and then once it comes out the membrane, this is a flow restrictor here. So that stops any water being wasted. So this system here is doing about one for one. 1 litre of waste down the drain, 1 litre of good water is going to be stored in the tank. So that drain there, we'll have the saddle, etc. here. This drain's going to, it's in the instruction booklet too, but this drain here will connect onto the kitchen sink waste water line, and that's where the drain water goes down the drain. This one here is going to connect into the tank, and then obviously the water will also come back from the tank, and because it's only one line runs to the tank, okay? So it'll come out of here, go to the tank. When the tank's full, it'll stop. When the water's going to come out of the tank, it'll go back along the same line, and it'll come back in here. It'll flow through the system, come out of here to our fourth line, which is going to go to the tap, and that'll be up onto the sink, and the water will flow out. So they really are a great little system, and if you're looking for a reverse osmosis system, then you can have some confidence in this one. It's been our greatest seller for some time, and it's an absolute ripper. And if you can need a hand with anything or whatever, give us a ring, and we're always here to happy to help. Thanks very much.